Welcome to Using Census Data with Excel. I'm Adam Heckman.
Now let's map this data. I'll say insert 3D maps, open 3D maps. Again, it goes out to Bing and it geotags all my points. And here it's automatically recognized my location as state or territory. What I want to do here is I want median income to represent the height of the column. And then, since I have year, I want to bring in year as my time dimension. And I can even tell it that this is a year. Now, again, a best practice always, name your layers. Median income by year. And you'll notice that as soon as I added a time dimension to this, it put a media bar at the bottom. Why did it put a media bar at the bottom? Well, it put a media bar at the bottom because now I can see how this data grows by year. Now notice that it's taking a look at this data by the second, and I really don't need the data by second, so I'll right-click on the date time and say edit, and have it, instead of giving me every second, just give me the year. And now let's see how that grows. So this is getting interesting, but again, I want to be able to know what my reference points are, so I'll click on map labels. And the other thing that I want to do is zoom out, but I also want it to move around for me while it's building out by year. That is a scene option. When you create these little video-like displays on your maps, they're called scenes. So I can give it a scene name and call it income by year. You'll notice that I can change the speed. I can slow it up or slow it down or speed it up. I can also give it an effect. So circle dolly figure eight, and I'll click on dolly. And you'll notice that what happens here when I click on play tour is that it's going to dolly around the states as it's growing. And the taxonomy here is what I've created as a layer. I've put the layer into a scene, and I can create multiple scenes and use them as a tour. And then when I'm done, I can share this by either doing a screen capture or creating a video in a variety of formats.